Trump administration officials claims the Philadelphia Eagles atteint to humiliate the president led to the team being disinvited from a White House event just before it was scheduled to happen. Politico reported Tuesday that when the White House learned the previously 81-person delegation from the team representing the city of Brotherly Love had been reduced to just 2 or 3 players, and the team's owner and mascot, Donald Trump, had a change of heart about the event. We feel like they wanted to publicly humiliate the White House and the president, one White House official told Politico. The events that had been in the making for months started to fall apart, Politico noted, when the Eagles on Friday began suggesting alternate dates for the event after players began dropping out. The suggested dates were seen, internally, an attempt to get out of a photo op with President Donald Trump, the report continued. All of the new dates proposed were during the period when Trump is scheduled to travel to Singapore to meet with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. Finally, the president said it was BS, another official said. Other staffers that spoke with Politico said some in the administration were taken by surprise at the last-minute guest change, and people in the press shop were reportedly given only a few minutes notice before the official White House statement announcing the cancellation went out on Monday afternoon. Later that same evening, Trump tweeted about the SNUB. The Philadelphia Eagles football team was invited to the White House, he wrote. Unfortunately, only a small number of players decided to come, and we canceled the event. Staying in the locker room for the playing of our national anthem is a disrespectful to our country and kneeling. Sorry, the Philadelphia Eagles football team was invited to the White House. Unfortunately, only a small number of players decided to come, and we canceled the event. Staying in the locker room for the playing of our national anthem is a disrespectful to our country and kneeling. Sorry, Donald J. Trump.